Coming up, it's Up, Up, and Away.
Turning the bubble into the balloon causes the balloon to turn the bubble into a ball.
So I started working on the project on Tuesday night. Out looking like jellyfish.
Creating incredible inflatables for clients around the globe.
He's the one who's ultimately responsible.
Is too funny. Steve Rooney's show is playing at the Black Lodge Theater, which is at the Galleria, on June 26th.
What?
Sean. I've given up trying to explain to people what I actually do for a living. Applied latex technician. I blow things up for a living. Whoa. Occupational hazards. Represent going somewhere far away. Brief description of myself, artist with an Irish background who works with balloons professionally. I've been performing all around the world in something like 35 countries over the past 20 years, making people happy with balloon art.
This is going to be a little bit different than you might have seen before, because I'm actually beginning with the genetical information.
Tell us a brief description about Sean.
Sean was a very precocious young man. He walked very early, he talked very early. He was reading at 3.
He's probably one of the most multifaceted people I know. When he was young, he was a gifted athlete, a gifted musician. I think he won every single academic award from science to art. He's one of the few people I know who can actually do a Rubik's Cube across the phone for you.
When you're pulling me from behind, I really want to pull up my pants, but I've got my hands full.
He gets things faster than I think anybody I know.
Sorry, I'm taking so long.
The first thing I twisted was a balloon dog. The first thing that I did that was large and innovative was a life-size Tyrannosaurus Rex.
An 8-foot animal in the living room greeting me as a welcome home gift. It was massive. So we put him outside and it was snowing bitterly. And he sort of shrilled.
My mom always said I was an artistic prodigy. So. 20 years she thought it was an accident. This sort of gave her a way out of it.
With my parents, they've been extremely supportive. They appreciate creativity and inventiveness. And they can see that I've managed to take care of a lot of my desires in life to travel and connect. When you're an artist, sometimes you have great years, sometimes you have tough years. And, you know, of course, like any parents, my folks want to see me doing well. So, in general, positive. It's not to say it's all been smooth sailing. It is a rather unconventional career choice.
His career? It wouldn't have been my first choice.
I don't think a career is really the term for what Sean has had. Sean has had a life. he has had no desire ever to be one thing. He's had a desire to delve into practically every area of every culture. So the balloons have been a focus. If it hadn't been the balloons, he would have found, I think, some other reason to travel around the world, meet interesting people, see things, do things that most people don't even think about.
I didn't choose this career, that this career chose me. There's a particular set of skills that I've had all my life that involve manual dexterity and geometric complexity. And this medium just happened to be the way that I could combine the creativity and the control into something that has taken care of my material needs. This has really been the only job that I've worked in my life. So as an artist, I have a lucky trajectory where I do get to earn my living doing something that I love.
Oh, I can only quote Pope Francis, who am I to judge?
A lot of the work that I do involves special techniques that I personally have developed. Some of the things that I have innovated specifically have involved using techniques, putting balloons inside balloons. And the music is the thing that I would consider to be the most unique contribution I've made to balloon art. You have your downs. In my career, there's really no comparison to one particular night, which was July 2001 at Just for Laughs. My show went so incredibly wrong that I still have a hard time believing it.
But he certainly got the talent to do the cool stuff. Look. Sean, tell me about this adventure of yours. That is the coolest thing.
Well, it was my big break. And unfortunately, it was my big break.
To give you an idea of how bad the show was, I put, thinking it would stop my hands from sweating, I put some roll-on deodorant on moments before I was stepping on stage. And it had the opposite effect. Instead of stopping my hands from getting sweaty and therefore slippery, I basically applied something like a lubricant to my hands and it wouldn't come off. And it rendered me incapable of even tying a knot. And the whole thing unfolded in a really embarrassing way. So much so, actually, the reviewer the next day in the Montreal Gazette gave it worst act and called it excruciatingly embarrassing. So that would be a low point.
With his personality, he turned it into a little success afterwards, and he wrote a play called Like a Lead Balloon.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is what a bazooka looks like inflated full. I've preloaded it. It is now prepared to send a balloon somewhere in this audience at roughly 100 miles an hour. This is a good part of the show to pay close attention. All right, ladies and gentlemen, balloonistics.
It was funny, it was sad, it was hilarious, and I enjoyed that very much. But normally I don't see his shows. He just does tricks for us.
I don't think I've ever actually been at any of his formal shows. Why would I?
Sometimes I come back to Toronto and I feel like I don't have as many friends here. It's here that I will feel like, you know, I've only got a few people I can touch, but when I'm in Paris or when I'm in London or when I'm in Amsterdam or in China, there's always a group of people who are interested and want to spend time with me.
So long, honey dear, where I'm bound, I can't tell. Goodbye is too good a word, baby. So I just say farewell. I ain't saying you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kind of wasted my precious time. But don't think twice, it's all right.